Brandon Leak, season 15, Howie's Golden Buzzer, but you went on to win the whole thing. Brandon Leak!
I imagined a very different life. Growing up in Stockton, California, in poverty, loss of my sister, fatherless childhood. Writing poetry became my big outlet.
All the things I wish we could have done, I played again and again and again, and I'm tired of playing God because I gotta come to terms with the fact that my sister ain't never coming back.
You know, the world shut down that day. They almost canceled the entire show.
We feel your pain, we feel your love, and you moved me to do this.
I still, to this day, don't think I've proven the point. A slew of people were like, oh, he only won because there wasn't an audience. This doesn't translate to a large stage. I looked at it as, all right, Brandon, you got more work to do.
Are you excited for your dad?
I'm immensely excited to finally give a live audience a good taste of what I do in person.
Okay, here we go.
See, brother. My man, Brandon Leak!
So yeah, I prepared to win. I'll show you that today.
This is my golden buzzer!
How does that feel, Brandon? All your performances were without an audience.
Yeah. Y'all tell me, how's it feel, baby? It feels about that good.
Yeah, and you are that good. How old are you now?
I'm a big 3-0 now, and I got two beautiful kids.
Yeah!
So, yeah.
Did your life change after AGT?
Oh, without question. You know, just my opportunities. You know, leaving a stage like this, America's largest stage, it provides doors that I never had before. You know, what I've been doing recently is helping the 12 schools in my city. And we're publishing 6,000 kids this year.
That's amazing. And what is the dream? Like, why even come back?
Oh, man, well, my biggest dream is to help elevate spoken word to a point where the people see it just as normally as every other art form.
You know what? I feel like on that same year that you won, I think that young girl who performed at the inauguration...
Amanda Gorman.
Yes. I think that you opened the door for 100%. Moments like that. And I cannot wait to see what you have in store next.
Thank you. While on a walk, I saw a transient man standing on the corner. And immediately, I reached into my pocket. Not so I could grab money or anything like that, but so I could get my phone, you know, so I could fake text or pretend like I was listening to music, because I figured my persistence to keep my distance would make it hurt less when I ignored his existence. It, at least for me, anyway. But then suddenly, a very peculiar smell emanating from the man invaded my nostrils. It reminded me of all the things that our culture deems worthy of throwing away. And the irony is, that's the same way that we would treat him. But then inside my soul, something said, Brandon, put your pride aside and go talk to that man. So I did. I asked if he could share with me a bit of his story. All he could do was say, glory, hallelujah, of course I can. He told me of a man who had everything. The people bowed down at his feet, and they allowed their praises to raise his stature to nothing less than God reincarnated in human flesh. Where I'm from, that's the Pharaoh complex, I'm pretty sure, but... You see, the issue with towering above all has never been that climb up, but that cataclysmic fall, back down to humility in which most don't survive. And I imagine him losing everything. And he told me, young man, don't be foolish. The reality is that I woke up and realized that your life only works when your life's work is worth your life. And I realized my life's work was worthless. Worthless, and this broke me. It broke me to see my reflection splintered, broken, barren. So I grabbed everything I could fit into these bare hands, and I ran till I couldn't run no more. It all seemed so real to him. You could see it ruminating in his eyes again and again. And he stopped my train of thought saying, young man, do you know why I smell like this? He said, I smell like this to remind myself that self-sufficiency will no longer keep me clean, because do you know why you wear those clothes? Is it simply to look appealing or to hide the fact that you're healing? Never in a million years did I think I'd take hygiene tips from a guy like this. But I did. And the craziest part is, as all these cars drove by, I wonder which one of us they thought was clean. So I guess the moral of the story is, you can never judge a book by its cover.
I remember watching that vinyl, and I never forget when. Who's that?
My daughter's over there.
Say hi, Dada.
Oh, hello.
Hi, Dada.
Can she come up?
Of course.
Yeah.
Come on, Boo Boo. Here, Boo Boo.
She's so cute.
Brandon, what's her name?
Her name is Aaliyah.
Aaliyah. Hello. She's taking away the limelight from you, Brandon.
Every day of my life.
She's so cute. No, I was gonna say, I remember that night, you know, I never in my wildest dreams would have thought someone with an act like yours could win AGT, but you won it because of obviously what you say, but also it's the way you deliver everything. I mean, you are brilliant.
Thank you.
Absolutely brilliant.
It's always very emotional when you speak because you talk about different things that we all deal with in life. You definitely evoke these kind of emotions in me, and I'm sure in so many other people that hear you speak, and you're special.
Thank you. Thank you.
You really are, Brandon. I think that you're doing exactly what it is you want to do, and that is moving people. And your words are so poetic, so in the moment. We're not only enjoying your performance, but the message is so clear. And thank you for moving us. And I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you guys so much.
Well done, Brandon.
That was really special.
He is special.
I'm so proud of you. You're so good.
I know you want to get back to mommy.
He's like a star.
I have to like fight with tears when he speaks.
He was good.
He's great.